Just about everybody in Jonathan Franzen's superb domestic epic Crossroads, Farrar, Strauss, and Giroux, 592 pages, out of 4, is dealing with a serious spiritual crisis. Russ, a pastor in the Chicago suburbs, feels his faith evaporating as he pursues a widowed member of his flock. His wife, Marion, feels old unspoken traumas resurfacing. Their eldest son, Clem, has given up his Vietnam War student deferment in a rash fit of moral recalibration. The novel is set in 1971 and 1972. His brother Perry is drifting into drug abuse for want of a religious center. By contrast, their teenage sister, Becky, discovers pot and finds God. Franzen's career-long fixation with writing hefty novels about white-bread nuclear families has a way of making the Twitterati's eyes roll faster than the reels of a slot machine. To critics, he's an anachronism, a chronicler of trite paternalism and a faded middle-class social order. But in prior novels The Corrections and Freedom, Franzen took an ironic approach to Midwestern suburbia. The unearned self-assurance that resides there isn't, for him, a reason to neglect it. Rather, its hypocrisies are as meaningful literary fodder as a war zone or climate change. So rather than a familiar trope, Crossroads is a hefty experiment. How far can you get exploring American ordinariness with a Tolstoyan depth? Quite far, it turns out. Through interlocking character studies, Franzen unearths not just Russ' middle-aged lusts but their connection to his failing grip on his flock, particularly the youth group, Crossroads, that a fellow pastor has elbowed him out of. Russ' mood wobbles from prideful to self-pitying. At one point he revels in the sweetness of being thrown upon God's mercy, of making himself so alone and so wretched that only God could love him. The other family members similarly use religion to either rationalize their actions or make themselves abject.